Without maintenance facilities, you probably wouldn't have trains running.
We're currently in the Oliver Bowen maintenance facility. It is Transit's most recent train facility that's been built. There's been a lot of things that, lessons learned about this facility that we'd like to incorporate into the new facility.
The main thing that we do here is we do preventive maintenance checks, we do running repairs, and we also do all the rebuild of all the undercarriage. We call them bogies, but that's the main, just what we do here. So a train comes in on the lane, the interior gets cleaned. At that point, they can verify if it requires any rail sand. They can also verify if it requires any windshield washer fluid. When that process is completed, the train gets driven through the train wash. As it goes through the train wash, the secondary part of that is air dry, and then the last part is it actually gets blown down. Most of what we work on when it comes to the maintenance on the trains is either in the sides of the train or underneath. To save us time, as opposed to having to lift the train up every single time you need to look at something, the pits are designed so that you can quickly jump in there, ergonomically set so that you're not too deep or not too low, so that you can quickly look at the components and do any repairs that are required. We do try to keep trains parked inside at all costs because of the weather.
Each LRT line needs a maintenance facility, and so we looked over the city and found a location out in Sheppard along the alignment that will fit our fleet. There's lots of requirements around the trains that we need to do when it comes to cleaning and maintaining, and so we need a spot to do that. And so that is the Sheppard facility. The Sheppard facility will be out on 130th and 52nd. It is in close proximity to the future Sheppard station.
I mean, it's the maintenance staff, the electromechanics, the preventive maintenance staff that are moving the trains, repairing the trains, cleaning the trains, washing the trains, and at the end of the day, keeping them safe for the passengers and the citizens of Calgary.